Today we'll discuss about the some few operators, length operator and a repeat operator, and after that we'll discuss about the concept of typecasting, and that one data type is converted into another data type. Okay. So we have two predefined function, we can say, that available perform the operation. In that, a repeat operator is there, and second one is a length operator is there. So the difference between repeat and length operator is, length operator is used to calculate the length of given string. Okay. So for example, if we have a string of PES College of Engineering, so it will calculate total length of that string. So that's why a predefined length function is available. And second, if you want to display our data multiple times, then a repeat operator is available. So let's discuss about that. Operators. So this one is a command string, so we'll enter into the Python. Now, assume that you can perform the repeat operator using int data type also and string data type also. So first of all, here I'm using x is equals to string data type. For example, here I'm using. So what does it mean here? X is a variable whose data type is a string. Because of dynamic typecasting, we can store that information directly. And at the time of execution, it will be treated as a string data type. So don't worry about that. There is no need to mention the data type in Python. So if anyone asks the question, what is the reason behind that? So you can specify the answer. Because of dynamically typed language, we need not specify the data type. We can specify. So let's discuss about the repeat operator. So in the repeat operator, we can print the given data into multiple times. Make a note of that. We can print existing data multiple times. It's not mandatory. आप मल्टीपल टाइम्स आप डेटा क्या कर सकते हो, प्रिंट कर सकते हो. डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. ओके, सो एक्स इज इक्वल्स टू पीएससीवी, दैट पीएससीवी विल बी स्टोर्ड इन एक्स. सो वी कैन यूज एक्स. हियर आई एम यूजिंग अ सिंबल कॉल्ड एज अ मल्टीप्लाई, एंड हियर आई एम यूजिंग अ टू. ओके, सो आई वांट टू डिस्प्ले द गिवन डेटा इनटू टू टाइम्स. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई डिड एक्स मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टू. सो वी गेट द मैच आउटपुट एज पीएससीवी, दैट पीएससीवी. ओके, so again x multiplied by 5 times, so we get the output as a 5 times. Okay. So what does it mean? Is multiply operator is used to display the multiple things. Okay, what, multiple copies of given data, we can say that you display the multiple copies of given data. So for example, here I'm using x is equals to 10. Now the value is overrided. Right now only I have x is equals to 10. So if you want to multiply this, so we can do that. So x is equals to 3, we get the 30 output. We get the 30 output. If you multiply x multiplied, similarly, it is majorly used for the string operation. We all know that this multiplication operator. So that means it will be multiplied with a given value. So don't worry about that. But majorly it is a work with a string operation. If your string is x is equals to, assume that for example, ABC and space, see that information will be stored in a X. Now, if you're trying to multiply the X is equals to 10 times, we get the 10 times out. So why we get the spaces? Because here I given the space. So that's why it look like a space. ABC 1 time, 2 time, 3 time, 4 time, 5 time, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So it will be print according to your spaces. जितने भी आपके spaces रहेंगे उसके हिसाब से print. ये this one, these are the 10th output. So we'll get the 10 output. If you want to 5 output, you will get the 5 output. So this is about the repeat operator. Another operator is also there. Another operator is called as a length operator, which is used to calculate the length of given operator, and it is a majorly used in the programming. Okay. So for example, if you calculate the length, then this operator are useful. Okay, so let's do the practical. And this let operator we can majorly use for the string also. So x is equals to, assume that here I have a PESCUA and I know that the length of the given operator is 6, but just I want to calculate the length of operator. So that is why we will use a function called as LEN, length function, okay, which is used to calculate the length of operator. But right now I am using a command prompt. Just I will use LEN of x, then we get the output. But whenever we write the same thing in a notepad or notepad plus plus programming kit, we need to use print function. Make a note of that, and we'll do that practical also. See, length of x will be 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So for example, again I will use the change value. Here I'm using the PES. I will use a space, college. Assume that this one is a string which will be stored in an array. It may be just make a note of that why I given this example, because Python or any other languages also consider the empty space. It will be also consider the empty space. Okay, so here I will calculate the length of x, we get the certain output, but just I will change the value PES space. The CU, just I will use PESCU, and here I am giving a space, so the value of length will be treated as 6. Make a note of that. That means it will calculate empty space also. If empty space is used in two different words, then it will be calculated. Make a note of that. So we get the value at 6. See, PES, these are three words, and CU, these are the two alphabets. And this one is at the triple alphabet. So 3 plus 2, we get the 5 alphabet, but there is empty space is also there. See, this empty space will be also calculated. So make a note of that. Length operator and repeat operator. Length operator is used to calculate the given length of given string, whereas repeat operator is used to perform the multiple display options. Okay. So similarly, if you want to perform this program by using a code or notepad plus plus, we need to use print function. Why? Because see, whatever we perform in the command prompt directly without a print function, that will be displayed. Make a note of that. Okay, command prompt pe jo bhi hum program karte hai na, to that will be displayed, that will be displayed on command prompt without a print function. But whenever we use the program by using notepad IDE tool, okay, when we create a file and after that we write a code, in that section we need to write we need to write print function. So just I will give the demo, after that we'll start the type concept, type casting concept, and it is very useful concept for you. Here I'm using the notepad plus plus. Okay, so now here we'll do the code. I would calculate the length of that given string also, and I want to display the repeat operations also. So see, here I am using a print and round bracket. So before that, just which function we need to use to calculate the length. So here I am using an ln function, and in that I will provide the x. But right now it will not displayed on the output window. So for that, here we'll use the print function, because the function within function print in round bracket. So in that case, now we can able to display the length of value. Okay. So again, I will use a print function, print in round bracket. I am using x multiplied by 2. Here I will give empty space. Okay. So we get the difference between 2. That program. So here I'm using a double quote just, and here I'm using len.py. My program is successfully saved. len.py will execute that by command prompt. So I think the command prompt is already open. Directly d colon, we get the d, cd pp programs. Just 1 million index. Unexpected indent. What line? Just 1 minute. Give the output PSUV Aurangabad. PSUV Aurangabad, we get the output. The lamp function len. We get the output. PSUV Aurangabad, repeat string PSUV Aurangabad, and the total length is 18. Let's check out about the length. 1, 2, 3, these are the 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and the empty space is 18. Okay. There is 18. Okay. So, like that, we can do the program. Okay. So make a note of that, but while doing the same program, we directly use the len function and we directly use x multiplicative functions. Okay, so make a note of that. Just ab jab program karte hain notepad plus plus say or any other file create karke. So in that case, we need to use print function. So this is about the length function and this is about the repeat function. So now the next concept. Now we need to use a typecasting. So what is a typecasting? The conversion of one data type into another data type called as a typecasting. So these are the predefined functions and this fundamental data type is also int is there, float is there, complex is there, bool is there, string is there. Now we need to do what? First of all, consider we are converting any other data type into int data type. So we'll do what? First, we'll check for float. Can we able to convert float into int? Can we able to convert bool into int, string into int, complex into int? Okay. Later on, similarly, float ke baare mein, can we convert int into float? Can we convert complex into float? Can we convert bool into float? Can we convert string into float? So, these are the all functions are available. Ye pure functions. And these are fundamental. When we remove this round bracket, open close in front of these fundamental data types, these are the fundamental data types. Okay. So, jab bhi aap aage likhte ho, it will be converted into function. That means we have ready 5 functions are available. Int, float, complex, bool and string. Just we need to test the data. Okay. So, how will test the data? So, here I will show you. So, for example, I want to convert the any data type. Any data type to int data type. I want to convert any other data type into int. So that means I will convert float data type to int data type. Okay. I will convert complex data type to int. I will convert bool data type. Convert string data type to what does it mean? So ये ऐसे perform करके हम देख सकते हैं कि ये पूरे convert को देखे by using what in that section we'll use int function. We'll use int function. This is the typecasting. So make a note of that. Typecasting is nothing but conversion. Data type. Another version of one data type into another data type called as a what? Okay. So similarly, this is the way to convert अदर डेटा टाइप टू द इन डेटा टाइप। सिमिलरली फ्लोट के लिए हम ऐसा ही करेंगे, फ्लोट यहाँ इंट की जगह फ्लोट होगा, इंट फ्लोट की जगह इंट होगा, इंट टू फ्लोट, कॉम्प्लेक्स टू फ्लोट, बुल टू फ्लोट, स्ट्रिंग टू फ्लोट, एंड दैट्स व्हाई वी यूज द टाइप कास्टिंग एज अ फ्लोट। सो लेट्स डू द प्रैक्टिकल सो यू विल गेट द आइडिया। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस डायग्राम विल कन्वर्ट द फ्लोट इन टू, here I am declaring the one variable, so x is equals to 10.5, and I want to convert this fractional value into integer. So can I able to do that? The answer is yes. But what about the precision of the value after precision? It will be neglected. Okay, so we have two different values, the value before the point and the value after the point. So while converting this value, see 10.5, 10.5 is a fractional number, we all know that. What about the integer? Isme integer kitna hai? 10 is an integer. Okay. 10 is an integer. What about 5? 5 is a fractional number, so it will be neglected. So in that case, what happens? So when we use int is a typecasting function and converts. So before doing that, just identify what type of data is. So type of x, we get the float data type. Now we are trying to convert into int, so that's why here I am using the type conversion function, is called as int. Among that, I will provide the value of x. We get the value is 10. See, we get the type value is a 10. So we'll identify this type, so type in round bracket, int of round bracket x. Why we use int round bracket of x? Because we are converting this fractional data type into integer, and after that we'll check the data type. See, we get the int data type. That means, can I able to convert the fractional numbers into int data types? Yes, we can. What about this 5 value? The 5 value is a fractional, so it will not convert it. What about this decimal whose base is a 10? So that value will be easily. That means we can say that we can easily convert fractional data type into integer data type. Okay, so here functions both useful while doing the programming. This predefined function, typecasting function, is very useful to do the programming. Okay, so that's why I taught whatever I taught, just listen it carefully, watch this video repeatedly and perform the task. At the end of this session, at the end of this internship, you will get the lots of knowledge. Okay. So this is about what? So one part is completed. So yes. Second, we'll check about the check for the complex data type. Can we able to convert the complex data type? Check. So here I can see. Okay, so here I will use Python, and here I will write x is equals to 2 plus 3j 2 plus. Value will be stored, so we'll check for the type, what type of data is, and this data type is a complex class. See, this one is a complex class. Now we are trying to convert this complex class into the int data type. So let's do that. So here I'm using int of x. So we get the value as, see, we did not get the value. What does it mean? What does it mean? We cannot able to convert this complex number into integer number. We cannot able to convert this complex number into integer. What is the reason behind that? What is the reason behind that? See, in the complex number, there are two different categories. First one is a real number, and second one is a imaginary number along with square root of minus one. That means this 2 is a real number, this 3 is the imaginary number, and this j is, the value of j is square root of minus one. So how we can convert this number into the integer number? If we get the fractional number, if we have some string data type, if we have some bool value, then we can easily convert it. But the complex, we cannot able to convert it. Make a Here we will write no, we cannot able to convert complex to bool. Now afterwards we'll discuss about the bool data type. In the bool data type, can I able to convert? The answer is yes, we can able to convert bool data type. What is the reason? What is the reason behind that? Because of the bool data type is represented in natural numbers also. That means one is called as a true and zero is called as a false. Okay, so let's do about that. X is equals to, here I will store the 2. I am trying to convert this true. So before that, I will check the type of true. Type of X, not true. See, the type is bool. We can use either X or either directly we can use a true. Don't worry about that. So this one is a bool. Okay, so we are trying to convert into int and round bracket. I am passing the value of X. We get the value as 1. See, we all know that the bool means in the bool data type, true is called as a 1. In numeric format, it is also treated as 1 and false will be treated as 0. And we already did that part practical. So here I will use false. And when I trying to convert this false into integer, then we get the 0 value. See, we get the 0. That means, can I able to convert the bool value into integer? So aisa bhi lag raha hoga, why these concepts are required? Sir, these concepts are required for doing the better programming. In that we are trying to develop a certain application, in that case we require a typecast operator. So for that reason we need to must know which data type we can able to convert into int, which data type we can able to cannot convert into int, like that stuff we also must know about that. Okay, so that's why we are trying to learn. So assume that X is equals to, here I'm performing addition, 2 plus 2 plus 2. So some value will be stored in X, and now I want to trying to convert this X into integer. So what will be the value? So true is 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1, that means we get the 3 value. See, we get the 3 value. That means we can able to convert bool data type into int data type. So answer is yes. So you need to create such a table for practice purpose. Okay. So the next one is can I able to convert string data type into int data type? So the answer is yes. We can able to convert the string data type into in data type, but there is some restriction. Okay, so in that case we need to provide the alphabet. In the alphabet we need to provide the numbers. Okay, so then and then we can able to convert it. Okay, for example, let's show X is in double quote, I will provide the value as a 10. Okay, Y in double quote, I will provide in the value as a 20. Okay. Now I am trying to perform the addition. What will be the output? Does anyone know about that? What will be the output? 30? Or any other output?
Concatenation.
Okay, the output will be the concatenation. That means we get the output as 10, 20. That we get the output as 10, 20. That means what? These are the string. X is a string and Y is also string. So if both are string, then it will perform the concatenate. So in that case, we can able to convert the value. So here I am using int round bracket of X plus int. Now when we trying to perform this operation, we get the output. That means this is a string. We can convert this string into int. But when we trying to convert like this, PESCOE. When you're trying to convert X is equals to PSU and into the int data type, then it will generate an error. See, it will generate an error. So the value with base 10 is a must be required. Okay, so make a note of that in that section. We can able to convert the string data type into into int data type, but mandatory we required a alphabet value, sorry, integer value. So in that I am using that 100. Okay. So Now I will check that what type of 100 is. What type of x is the value is string. Now I am trying to convert int round bracket x. And this I will put it into type operator. See. So when we convert it, we get the int value. Conversion ke baad mein hame int value milne wali. But there is one problem in that. So x is equals to 100.5. Now this is a fractional value. This one is a x is equals to 100.5. And now I am trying to convert it into integer. So can we convert? The answer is no, we cannot able to convert. In the round double quote, it is mandatory to provide the int value only. Iske andar, we all know that it is a string value, but inside that we must provide the int value. When we are trying to provide the fractional value inside that x, then we cannot able to convert into. So this is about what typecasting of int. So ek problem hua hai solve, typecasting of int. Similarly, if you want to provide दूसरा करना है तो हम दूसरा भी कर सकते लाइक दैट. सो वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. एनी अदर डेटा टाइप. Here we did that, yes. Change that value. So let's discuss about the float data type. See, we already did float to int, string to int. See, I have given this and I will share this document also. Yeah, recording to ho rahi hai. You can check it recording also. See, in that I am trying to send the fractional value and we are trying to convert this fractional value into the integer. So we get the error as a value error. Make a note of that. We need to understand the types of error also. Type error and value error. Okay, so a value matlab directly deals with the particular value. Okay, so isse aapko pata chalega ki syntactical error hai ya dusra kuch error. So see, complex data type, complex to int. We cannot convert string complex data type to int data type. Ye convert nahi kar sakte. That's why we here I have given the options also. int of x, we cannot able to. Now this about the float data type. So into float, we can convert int data type into float data type. Matlab kya hai ki float to int ho sakta hai. Okay, so don't worry about that. Abhi floats ke different types of ways are available. We all know that in the float data type we have binary, we have octal number, we have hexadecimal also. In that section we can able to convert it. So let's check out Python. In that x is equals to, assume that we have the value as a 10, and now I'm trying to convert. So before that I will change the type of x. We get the int data type. Okay, so now I'm trying to convert it into float. So for that I will use a float function. For that I will use float function, so float of x. So this is what, this is about the decimal number. Integer number mein hum four ways and different convert kar sakte. For example, binary is there, fractional is there, afterward octal is there, and hexadecimal is there. So these are the four different, decimal, binary, octal and hexadecimal. These are the four different ways. We can able to convert this integer number to fractional number. Okay, So let's took another example. X is equals to 0. P stands for binary, and here I will give 1111. These are the 4 times 1. Okay, what does it mean? The value of decimal is 50, and we are trying to convert this binary number into what? Into float number. So let's check out X is equals to value, and I'm trying to convert into float. So we get the 15.0. Similarly, you can do perform. We can any operations. That section also we can use octal number. So X is equals to 0. We can use a smaller O and capital O also. Don't worry about that. We cannot able to use capital O and small O. So we can use small O as well as capital O. So here I will use 1 2 1 0 1 like that, sir. And I am trying to convert this octal number into fractional number. Then we can convert this octal number into fraction. Similar for the hexadecimal is also. So 0 hexadecimal ke liye, what we use hexadecimal, X or A. Use X, and here I will use A. After that, here I am converting this number into the what we say fraction. See, we get the 1 7 2 times A. If you're trying to use only one single A, then it will use A 10. Okay, so this is about what this is about. Typecasting integer to float, that means yes, the answer is yes, we can able to convert it. Okay. So later on we'll check bool to float, can we able to convert? Yes, easily, don't worry about that. Bool to a term easily kar sakte, because what whenever you use the bool value, we get the integer outputs, either 1 or either 0. Just give me 1 minute. So what about the bool value? So whenever we perform the bool values, bool data type, we get the values of integer or value of 1 or 0. Okay, so for example, X is equals to true. When we print that X, we get the true, and when we convert that X, we get the 1 value. See, so we all know that false we get 0 and true will get wow. Okay, so now I'm trying to convert into float. See, here I'm using the float function, and round bracket I will use X. So we get the 1.0. Instead of 1, we get the 1.0. Okay. So similarly for float also, when we perform the float operation, in that section also we get the fractional value. So let's do that. X is equals to poles. Into float of X, we get the 0.0. So simply the meaning of that, can we able to convert bool to float? The answer is yes. String to float, yes. Similarly, we can able to convert string to float. So again, mandatory things is that alphabet nahi honi chahiye, number hona chahiye. String to convert karna 10.5. Okay, so this one is a string, so we'll check the type of X. We get the output as a string, so we are trying to convert it into float. We get the output 10.5. So abhi aisa bhi question aa sakta hai ki pichli bar hum int mein kiya tha to error aa raha tha, abhi problem nahi aa raha. So make a note of that. When we use a string, and when string contains some fractional, whenever we trying to convert into int, फ्रैक्शनल वैल्यू को हम इंट में कन्वर्ट करेंगे तो ही एरर आएगा, बट फ्रैक्शनल वैल्यू को हम फ्रैक्शन में कन्वर्ट करेगा तो वी डोंट गेट एनी एरर्स, मेक अ नोट ऑफ वी डोंट गेट एनी एरर्स। ओके सो दैट मींस कैन बी एबल टू परफॉर्म, यस। लास्ट वन इज रिमेनिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स, सो कैन वी कन्वर्ट द कॉम्प्लेक्स डेटा टाइप स्ट्रिंग टू फ्लोट, वी डिड दैट, बुल टू फ्लोट, कॉम्प्लेक्स डेटा टाइप, द सिंपल आंसर इज वी कैन नॉट कन्वर्ट द कॉम्प्लेक्स डेटा टाइप इनटू फ्लोट डेटा टाइप। व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दैट, बिकॉज सी हमने इंटीजर में भी जो भी रीजन दिया था वही ये रीजन यहाँ देंगे, सो द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ रियल पार्ट प्लस इमेजिनरी पार्ट प्लस स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ माइनस वन, सो दीज वैल्यूज आर कॉम्प्लेक्स, सो वी कैन नॉट एबल टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू फ्लोट, सी वी हियर वी गेट द एरर, x is equals to 2 plus 3z and we are trying to convert that float in, so we get the type error, syntactical error, so we use the type error, so in that case we cannot able to convert, make a note of that. So ये differences आपको पता होने चाहिए, make a note of that, and these differences are useful, so इसके लिए कौन से types के लिए typecasting हो सकती है, so we can use int typecasting, we can use float type. str type casting and after that complex, that just we did that about we did about what int and float, and I think just I will check the time of meeting, so only 15 minutes are available and we started at 8:30, so only we have 9 minutes. 9 minutes are remaining, so we can do one more practical. The maximum limit will be 50 minutes. Just complex. So complex का तो हमने देख लिया है, there are two types forms, x plus 0z and x plus. Let's do that complex type casting. It took more time for a term complex type casting. Instead of that, we'll do another type casting. This complex will do in lateral. Full type pass type casting. Check out for all the terms. So let's check out, we need to convert the any other data type into bool data type. So for that we'll discuss about that. So first of all, we are trying to convert the int into bool. Okay. So for example, if we have the bool data type, if you want to convert the bool data type, sorry, int data type into bool data type, the answer is yes, we can able to convert the any value. So for example, assume that just we have two values are available, because the true and false, true represents one and false represents the zero. Okay, so when we're trying to convert this two values, for example x is equals to one, and where I'm trying to convert into bool of x, then easily it will be converted, easily it will be converted. Okay, so when we're trying to x is equals to zero, value into bool, then this also easily converted. See, bool of x we get the true value and bool of y we get the false value. But इसमें ना थोड़ा सा ये भी क्वेश्चन आता है कि कैन वी पास ओनली टू वैल्यूज, इफ want to pass greater values, then what about that? So ये भी function उन्होंने दिया है कि if you want to pass another value, that means positive value, then it will be always treat as true value. For example, bool of x, it will be always treat as a true value. Okay, that means one के ऊपर जितने भी values रहेंगे, it will be treated as a true. अगर वो x is equals to माइनस वैल्यूज है, जीरो के नीचे जितने भी वैल्यूज है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल -100, देन इट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज फॉल्स वैल्यू. बट जस्ट मेक अ नोट ऑफ दैट कि आपको आपको जो चेंजेस करने हैं. ये दिखा रहा है माइनस के भी ट्रू दिखा रहा है, माइनस वैल्यूज के भी ट्रू. मेक अ नोट ऑफ दैट, ये बाकी के वैल्यू के साथ में आपको कुछ भी लेना देना नहीं है. व्हाट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दैट? वी ऑल नो दैट द ट्रू मीन्स व्हाट? वन. न्यूमेरिक ट्रू मीन्स व्हाट? न्यूमेरिक ट्रू मीन्स क्या होता है? सी, हियर आई एम यूजिंग and I am trying to convert it into int. We get only one value, so we need to focus on these things also. Okay, so true or false के बारे में हमें focus करना है, don't worry about other types. So can we convert into int into bool? Yes, but limited condition, limiting. We get the message that meeting will be ended in 5 minutes, so we took fast. Just we'll do that. Can we convert the float data type into bool data type? So we can convert the float data type into bool data type. Just we need to take care about the 0,0 value and 0 dot value. Okay. So when we get the 0,0, it will be treated as a false. When we get the greater than 0,0, that means 1,0 and any other value, then it will be considered as true. Make a note of that. So complex number, complex, can I convert into complex? We cannot given convert. We can convert. See, complex number is also there. Type casting complex to bool. We can convert the complex data type into bool, but how? So if the 0,00 value is there, then it will be treated as a false. If 0 plus 1 or any value that will be positive will be treated as. If we get only real number and image number will be 0. Then it will be treated as. So ये पार्ट हम कल रिवाइज करेंगे वन मोर टाइम. सो जस्ट आई विल टेक द अटेंडेंस, बिकॉज अटेंडेंस इज मैंडेटरी एंड द मीटिंग विल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद इन अ 2 मिनट्स. सो गिव मी सेकंड्स, आई वांट टू सेव.